My mom had an old black Singer, and I have a memory of her sewing on an old black Singer. She didn't sew a lot, but when she did, I was absolutely fascinated. So really, for me, it's about these warm and fuzzy memories I have of my mom.
This is Wheeler & Wilson. It's my personal favorite. It was from Bridgeport, Connecticut. My father was a mechanic, and he taught me how to like mechanics. And mechanically, Wheeler & Wilson got it right.
Extension table goes out, and over in here is where I had to rebuild this whole area. And yes, so this machine could sit down in there. You can see it lifts. So now it's flush.
I always wanted to do a hands-on job, so I stuck with the family business. I started to sew, I started to make garments. I was pretty happy. I made skirts, I made pants, blind stitch, I did the mirror, I did the buttonhole, I did the button.
A woman contacted me and she has a nine-year-old granddaughter. She wanted to get her a vintage machine. So she said, I'd like to get her a featherweight. So I did beautiful work on this featherweight and included a bunch of stuff that I thought that a young kid would like a pin cushion that was bright yellow with clowns on it, and put that together because it was a birthday present for her ninth birthday. And she absolutely was, she was so taken back. The messages I was getting from this woman were almost making me cry.
It was strong, it was smooth, it was quiet. Singer bought them out and put Singer where it says Wheeler & Wilson and had this exact model. They did not change one bit of it when Singer took the company over. So this is my favorite machine because mechanically it was amazing.
This one has most of its decals are still pretty intact. Either they use these machines constantly and they wore them off, but most of the decals are worn off, but this one is still pretty well there.
Again, as you can see, I'm still playing around with these domestics. I can't say no.
She knows she's giving her this all metal machine that's already lasted 70 years. Now it's like brand new and it's gonna last for another 70 years. This girl is gonna have that machine for the rest of her life, and that was her connection to her granddaughter.
I have named most of my machines. This one I call for my sister, so this is called Kate. My sister passed away about 3 years ago of kidney failure. So she had this and she sewed kids' clothes on it, and she sewed a lot of her own clothes on it. She sewed kitchen curtains on it, everything that women in the 1960s were sewing.
We bought the treadle machine. We got them down to like $50. She says, oh, by the way, I have another sewing machine that was my mom's that she brought over from Holland in 1950. I don't know if I pronounce this right. It's L-A-E-A, Lada. And they made cars. It's a hand crank. And it's a great machine. It's quiet. And I think a lot of hand crank enthusiasts would love this machine because it's unique. You don't see many of these at all.
So there's a very personal nature to the collection of these machines because of these are going to last for a long time. If I give it as a gift, it's going to be there forever. They feel this way. They find these machines, they feel like it's their, it's their mission. They need to do this. This is, they're doing a great job, a great thing by pulling this machine out of that thrift shop instead of it landing in the dump. How dare you throw an old vintage machine into the dump?
My dream would be that someday I would get on Craigslist in Detroit and find my mother's machine. In 1984, my dad said to my mom, you ought to get a modern machine. And so he went out and bought her a Kenmore. Somebody in Detroit bought my mother's machine. And I hope it's just sitting somewhere in somebody's house being used, or at least gathering dust, that someday I'll go on the Detroit Craigslist and I'll find an ad for a Singer 6616 in a white cabinet with a white light. And I'll pay $1,000 to buy that machine.